sleep is never an option, especially when you have a situation of hope.
Right.
With a Dr. Jogger. Mm-hmm. All right, let's see what he can do.
When Bobby Christina Brown was on, was in a coma, it was actually her father, Bobby Brown, who wanted to bring in this Dr. Jolly, and who's actually a spiritual healer.
The Houston family, they were at wit's end. You know, Bobby Christina is in a hospital. She's still breathing. You know, it's easy for us to look at and say, you know, hey, she's brain dead, pull the plug, do whatever, you know. But for a family, any family, it's hope against hope, to the point where, you know, the Houston family brought in some sort of holistic doctor, you know, who actually got Bobby Christina to respond for a second, or to appear to respond.
I prayed for 6 months to go help Bobby Christina Brown. I knew no one. I did not know anyone, but I just would pray. Bobby called. He called and he contacted me and gave me the permission to go and help his daughter.
This is somebody that came in and said, you know, that he had this big couple of gallons of juice and was going to try to heal this child. And he said, no, she's not in a coma. Even like medically, she's in a coma. And Dr. Jolie said, no, that's not a coma. She's got life in her, and we're gonna heal her from the inside and the outside.
Pat Houston and a couple of her family members told Bobby, no, he can't come in. So they started screaming and shouting, he can't go in, he can't go in. No, no, they put up a big, big fight. And so the security guys at the door of Bobby Christina's room door, they told Pat Houston that if Bobby Brown, the father, wants to bring his own guest in, he could do it, regardless of what the list was. Pat Houston and her family got very upset because the security overrode her decision and they allowed me to come into the room. To the room, the first thing I noticed that she was lying in a bed with nothing connected to her. I've never been in a hospital, seen a person just receiving nothing, no IV, no food, no, just nothing. It kind of blew my mind for a moment. Okay, so after viewing that, I told Bobby, I said, well, I'd like to get started.
It felt horrible, man, looking at her like that, you know, especially in the hospice. And then on top of the fact that everyone's just acting weird and funny and like, this is serious. Like, why? What? It was just a lot of bad vibes from everybody. Such as Pat and, you know, that side. Acting funny about us trying to go see Chrissy or being there. Like, hey, like, we shouldn't be there or something like that. And it's like, y'all are treating us like outsiders. Like, we're close with her. Like, you can't treat us like that. You know, they didn't really want us around like that. You can tell. They will never directly say it, but you can tell. Hey, I didn't like that. Especially during a hard time like that, with her being like that, and she needs support.
When I got there, it was a matter of me dealing with a person that I knew had been struck upside the head. She'd been beat, and the family was expecting her to die.
The world thinks Chrissy was in a coma. No, she was not. Chrissy was wide awake. Her eyes were open every single day. She was communicating back and forth with us, and she knew what was going on around her. And he said when she saw Pat, she said, Bobby Christina started doing this. He said the closer Pat got to Chrissy, the louder she moaned.
She was trying to tell Bobby Brown everything, but she could not get it out. She could not get it out. Now, when this was happening, all of a sudden, Pat Houston walked into the room. When Pat Houston walked into the room, she walked close to Bobby Christina. When she was about 6 feet away from Bobby Christina, Christina started growling like a pit bull. She went like,